So we look at the issue of prevalence of metabolic health in American adults. And there are certain indicators for metabolic health, which are blood glucose, triglycerides, HDL, blood pressure, and waist circumference. And this gives us a general idea of how a person is doing when we look at these different things. Now, in my clinical practice, for just about every adult, whether you're on whatever medication, I like to check all of those, all right? Simply because you're seeing me, if you haven't had lab work done in the last year, and especially if you're over the age of 30, especially if you're over the age of 40, if you're over the age of 50, I'm doing it, all right? And the main reason is I want to identify other issues that may be going on that may be affecting your health. So in this particular latest study, they showed that only 1 in 8 Americans met criteria for optimal health, with 88% of us at some risk of metabolic syndrome. Be it your blood pressure, your cholesterol, your triglycerides, your HDL numbers, only 1 out of 8 of us are in optimal health. So diagnosis of metabolic syndrome, for men, waist circumference greater than 40, for women, greater than 35. High triglyceride levels, low HDL, less than 40, blood pressure greater than 130 over 85, with an elevated fasting glucose greater than 100. So when you look at these numbers, only 1 in 8 Americans are not having an issue with at least one of these particular areas. So we're getting sicker, all right, as a group. And oddly enough, for the first time in American history, it is thought that our children will not live as long as us. All right, so we're actually going backwards when it comes to overall likelihood of living longer. The age of life is actually going backwards.